Hezbollah has carried out one of its deadliest attacks of the war so far, killing four Israeli soldiers at a military base in the country's north. The Iran-backed terror group claims that it launched a swarm of drones, overwhelming Israel's air defence systems, which failed to stop the strikes. While just a few hours ago, Israel launched an attack of its own, this time on Gaza, where a hospital was hit, killing three people. It is the latest attack in the war as the world watches on to see when and how Israel will retaliate against Iran.
The injured arrived by air and in ambulances. Critically wounded victims rushed to hospital after a surprise attack by Hezbollah. The terror group says it fired a squadron of drones towards northern Israel, some targeting a military training camp. At least four soldiers were killed and more than 60 people were hurt. The strike came just hours after the United States confirmed it is sending an anti-missile system to Israel and American troops to operate it. The US says it will help prevent future attacks from Iran. No! Israel is still yet to respond to this wave of drones fired at Tel Aviv earlier this month. That retaliation is likely to set the course for the ongoing war as Israel's ground offensive and airstrikes in Lebanon continue. UN peacekeepers have come under attack again, with Israeli tanks smashing through a gate at a base. The IDF claims it was an accident and happened as it was evacuating its soldiers. But Benjamin Netanyahu has ordered the United Nations to withdraw the peacekeeping force.
Mr. Secretary General, get the UNIFIL forces out of harm's way. It should be done right now, immediately.
Those peacekeepers are made up of 10,000 soldiers from 50 countries. They've been here since 1978 when Israel first invaded Lebanon. And they say they're not going anywhere. John Paul Gonzo for 10 News First.